What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create SEO optimized blog posts on Google Blogger. And this will basically help you attract more traffic from Google Search. So right here, I am on this Google Blogger account and I'm going to show you step by step how you can create a new post and all the things you need to do to start getting people to find your post, your blog on Search. And if you are new to Blogger, I have a number of tutorials on this channel that will show you how you can set up a blog for free on Blogger, customize your blog, and do all the necessary stuff you need to do. So I'll link those videos down below in the description so I can check them out after this video. What you need to do after logging into your Blogger account is to click on New Post here to open the content editor. But since we don't just want to write a random blog post, we actually want to optimize our blog post to rank in Google Search. So we are not just going to start typing in random titles, random content right here. We are going to do a little bit of research, and that's very, very important. The mistake a lot of new bloggers make is to write blog posts without adequate research. And I'm going to show you how you can do that here. Now, when it comes to search engine optimization, there are two phases to SEO. The first stage is the on-page SEO, and these are the activities you carry out while creating your blog post. And then the second stage is the off-page SEO, and these are the activities you do after you've created your blog post, stuff you do outside your website to boost your site's ranking on Google Search. And I'm going to cover both stages in this video, starting from on-page SEO. Now, I want to write a blog post. The first thing to do is to find out the keyword you want to rank for. Your blog post should be targeting a particular keyword. Even though your post can show up for different search queries, you should be targeting one specific keyword, and how you can get to rank as high as you possibly can for that particular keyword. And the first step towards achieving that is by finding out the keywords people type in on Google when they go to search for what your content is about. And to do that research, I use this tool called Uber Suggest. So just visit neilpatel.com/ubersuggest. I also drop the link in the description, and sign up if you don't have an account yet. Create a new Uber Suggest account and then come over to the keywords, come over to keyword overview. And what we want to get here is to look for keywords that people are searching for enough. Also, keywords that are not very difficult to rank for. Okay. And what you want to do once you log into your Uber Suggest account, come over to keyword overview and type in the keyword you are targeting. Now, let's say I am creating a blog post on search engine optimization. I'll come over here and type in search engine optimization. All right. So you select your target language and your target location, and I'll click search. And as you can see, all of this insight that Uber Suggest is going to give you, search engine optimization gets an average monthly search of 6,600, as you can see right here. But the SEO difficulty is very, very high. That means it's going to be very hard to rank at the top for this particular keyword. Okay, the average web page that ranks in the top 10 has over 190,000 backlinks and a domain authority of 90. Now, if you are a new blog, you will likely not have all of this. All right. So even though this keyword gets a very high search volume per month, but it's also very difficult to rank for it. So you don't want to go for this kind of keyword. You want to look for keywords that have a fairly high search volume, but are not this difficult to rank for. So what you want to do is scroll down over here, and here you have suggestions you can create content around for this particular keyword. But what you want to do is to come over to related so that you can see other keywords related to this keyword you are targeting, but are not going to be this difficult to rank for. So you can see here, best search engine optimization companies. How does search engine optimization work? This does not get as high search volume, gets an average of 390 search, but the search difficulty is very low, just 12. So this will be a very good keyword to target as a new blog. What is search engine optimization? This does not get as many searches as this, so I'm going to pick this for instance. And so here you can see the top results for this particular keyword. How does search engine optimization work? So you see the blogs that are ranking for this keyword and the traffic these particular web pages get from Google, the backlinks they have, the domain authority, and the number of social shares they have. And as you can see here, the average page that ranks in the top 10 has over 20,000 backlinks and a domain authority of 55. Now, this keyword I will have here called how do search engine work is also known as a long tail keyword. And this is really what new bloggers can use to get their blog off the ground. All right. So I'll be targeting how do search engine optimization work. And this is what the blog post that I'm about to create will be about. So I'm going to check this and then click on copy to clipboard to copy selected. Then what I'm going to do right now, usually I don't like typing my content right here on Blogger. So I like creating first on Google Docs, then I can just transfer everything back to Blogger. So I'm going to open Google Docs right now. So yeah, I'm going to type in title and paste how does search engine optimization work. And it is very important that you have the keyword you are targeting in your post title. Okay, so that's why I have how does search engine optimization work. Because your title is one of the first ranking factors search engines use to rank your post. So how does search engine work? You can add further details, right? Maybe a beginner's guide to SEO. All right. So this could be my title, but this is the main keyword that I'm going for. Also, if I copy this particular keyword, how does search engine optimization work? And I come back to Uber Suggest, come back to keyword overview. Then I type that in here, how does search engine optimization work? I'll click on search. So 390 monthly search volume on average, SEO difficulty 12, very easy. And if you scroll down here, you see content ideas, how does search engine optimization work? So you can get inspiration from this content idea section. But basically right now, I've gotten what I need from Uber Suggest, and that's the keyword I should be targeting. Don't forget, a keyword that have a fair amount of monthly search volume and very easy to rank for. Now, the next thing I'm going to need to do is to plot out the outline for my content. Now, when writing your blog post, one thing you should always have in mind is you should always write for the searcher. Write so that your article will meet the need searchers have when they search for this particular keyword, okay? A lot of people make the mistake of focusing excessively on how to rank, that they overemphasize the number of keywords in the article, the length of the article, and all those sorts. But the most important thing is make sure that your article is what readers will find very, very helpful. Remember, what search engines want to do is to match searchers with what they are searching for. Search engines are not looking for the longest post. They are not looking for the post with the most keyword inside. They are looking for posts that will meet what searchers are searching for. So if you want these search engines to rank your post, make sure that your article is valuable enough to give people what they are looking for. So let's get to the next part, which is writing your article properly. If this is a topic you are good at, you can just go ahead and start writing. But I like doing research in my writing process. And one very simple trick I use to really write articles that people will find helpful is to find out the questions people are asking about this particular keyword, right? So my main keyword here is search engine optimization. What are the questions people are constantly asking about search engine optimization? So how do I get those questions? I use a tool called answerthepublic.com. So if you visit answerthepublic.com, you can type in any keyword right here, and Answer the Public is going to give you the most popular questions on the internet related to that keyword. So for instance, here I'll type in search engine optimization. Then you can change the location. Let me use Nigeria here and then click on search. So if I scroll right down, you see the most searched questions about search engine optimization. So you have them in different categories: what, why, can, how, and other sorts. So what I can just do is to pick some questions here and try to answer them in my blog post. That way, I'm really providing what people are looking for. So I'm going to go through all these questions now and pick some of the ones I can use on my article. All right, so I'm done surfing through the questions and I've picked some of the points that I think will help the article I'm about to create. Okay, so here I have what is search engine, why search engine optimization is important, what is the purpose of search engine optimization, how can SEO help your business, how SEO work, how SEO is done, where to learn SEO, right? So you basically want to pick out those points that will be valuable to your content and to your readers. And this could form the different sections I will have in my article. Also, you can check other articles that are showing up on Google as regards to this topic, and you see the structure and you see the kind of topics that cover. So let's say this is what I'm going to work on. And what I just need to do now is to fill up all of this, like explain what is search engine, why search engine optimization, what is the purpose of search engine, and that becomes very, very easy. So I'm just going to type in something very brief here because I'm not actually writing a blog post. I just want to show you the process. So let's say, for instance, here I'll type in search engine optimization or SEO is the process of maximizing number of visitors to a particular website and all those stuff. And basically just type in everything you need and you are good to go. So let's say I'm done writing my article. It's time to start posting on Blogger, right? So first I'll copy the header and come back here to our content editor and paste my title. And then what we need next is the main body of the text. I'll paste that here as well. Now you can use these editors right here. So you can change the font type. Let's say I want to make this bold. I'll just click on bold. Or make this a heading or a subheading. You can really play around with this. You can add images. You can hyperlink. You can change text background color, text color. If you want to change the text color, you can do that here. The alignment and all the stuff. You can add a video. Okay, you can add emojis and special characters. So let's say I want to add an image to this post. Now, images are very, very important, aside from the fact that it makes your post looks good, like they add color to your post. It is also an opportunity for you to tell search engines what your blog post is all about. All right, so let's say under what is search engine optimization, I want to add an image here. I will come over. You can come over to Google and search for what is search engine optimization, then come over to images, and then let's say I want to add this image to my blog. I'll click on it, open the blog post, and then copy image address, then come over here and click on insert image by URL, then paste the image URL, and then click select. All right, so I've added this image to my post. Then don't forget to add an alt text. So I'll click on this. Click on this gear icon and then alt text. I'll type in image showing how search engine optimization works. Your alt text is very, very important so that people using browsers or software that cannot load images will get to know what the image you have here is all about. And it also tells search engine crawlers what your image is all about. For the title, I could just use how SEO works. Alright, so I'll use medium size and then click update. Medium is too small, so I'll increase the size. Let's use large. Let's see. That's quite small too. I'll use original size and click update. So let's say this is what we've got. You can just go ahead and create a very valuable content. And don't forget to make your content unique. Search engines like Google value uniqueness. If you just copy any article from another website or another blog post and paste on your blog, Google is going to see it as a duplicate and it's not going to rank your post. Okay, so it's very important that you have unique content. So here I'm going to use image credit or Balo, which is like where I got the image from. Okay, so these are just some basic steps you can take while creating your blog post. Also, if you notice that I have search engine optimization popping up at different points in my blog post, and that's because that's the keyword, that's the main keyword I am targeting, search engine optimization. So you want to have the main keyword you are targeting pop up in different places in your blog post. But that does not mean you should mindlessly add your keywords to your blog post. You want to make sure that it makes sense, makes meaning to the readers, and you'll be good. Okay, now let's say you are done writing your blog post. Before you publish, there are certain things you need to put in place. First of all, come over to permalink and you want to create a custom link for your blog post. Right now I have topdex/how-does-search-engine-optimization-work. This is very, very important because this is the keyword I'm targeting. All right, so it's very important that you also have your keyword in your URL. So here's what I want to have on my URL: the title of my blog post. Okay, so how does search engine optimization work? And then the next thing you want to do is to go down to options. If you want people to be able to comment on your post, you can do that here, but I don't want to allow comments. I'll turn it off. Also, if you've added your blog to Google Search Console, you'll see a space to add your search or meta description right here. So there you just want to type in what you want people to see on Google search result page. That's very, very important. And that's also one of the key ranking factors search engines use to rank blog posts. I don't have that space here because I've not submitted this particular blog to Google Search Console. All right, so submit your blog to Search Console and add your sitemap as well. I've created a tutorial to show you how to do that before. So if you come over to my channel, let me show you that video. Yeah, so here is video how to add and verify blogger on Google Search Console. And that is very, very important for you to do. And that will basically enable Google to crawl and index your site. Very, very important. So if you do that, you'll be able to enter a meta description for your blog post here. So for instance, if you go on Google and search for a particular key term, so let's say this, for instance, here you have the URL, the title, and then you have this very short description here telling you what this post is all about. And this is what's called the search description or meta description. If you don't do that, you are not going to be showing up in search, okay? It's that important. So once you are done with all of these things, you just want to click on publish to publish your blog post. So let's say I want to see what this post will look like on the web. I can just click on preview. And this is what it looks like. So once you are done publishing your article, you can decide to add your blog articles, the articles you have on your blog, into different categories by adding labels to them. Let me say SEO and click apply. So you can create different blog posts and add them to different categories. You are basically through with the first stage of search engine optimization, which is on-page SEO. The next phase now is the off-page SEO, and this is where you start getting external traffic and backlinks to your blog. And what you basically want to do is to start getting traffic from other places, from social media, Facebook, from forums like Quora. You can also use Pinterest to achieve that. Getting external traffic to your blog can be a big boost for you as a new blog. Also, you need to get backlinks. If I come over to UberSuggest, you see that the top ranking pages have a lot of backlinks. Backlinks are very, very important. Then you can start reaching out to other bloggers in your niche and request that they send links to your website, maybe in exchange of you sending links back to them or whatever the cost may be. But getting backlinks to your blog help you rank higher. You can also start with internal linking. That's linking one post on your blog to another post on your blog. That's also one very basic and simple way you can build links for yourself. So if you have a lot of blog posts, you try as much as possible to link them up to each other. But the major work is getting links from other websites to your own website. So guys, this is the basic process you can follow to create SEO optimized blog posts on Blogger. I hope you found the tips in this video helpful. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button and let me know down below in the comment section. And also, if you had to subscribe to the channel, make sure you subscribe before you go. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.